The shielding effect, and its trends in the periodic table, are presented in this small video. Shielding effect is the decrease in the attractive force, exerted by the nucleus, on the valence shell electrons due to the presence of inner electrons. Inner electrons are the electrons present between the nucleus, and the outermost shell of the element. The outermost shell is also called valence shell. Let's start from the hydrogen element. Hydrogen is the first element of the periodic table. It takes place in the first period and in the first group. The atomic number of hydrogen is 1, which means it has one proton in its nucleus, and therefore, only one electron is rotating around the nucleus in its first shell. In hydrogen, the first shell is also the valence shell, since no other shell is required for accommodating the single electron. As a result, there are no inner electrons present in hydrogen. Nucleus will attract the only electron, with its full force, which is called nuclear charge. The nuclear charge is shown by the purple arrow throughout this video. Since there are no inner electrons in hydrogen, therefore, the nuclear charge will not be affected by any electron, and hence, the shielding effect is zero in hydrogen. Now let's take a lithium element. Lithium takes place in the second period and in the first group. The atomic number of lithium is 3, that means it has 3 protons in its nucleus, and therefore, 3 electrons are rotating around the nucleus. For accommodating these 3 electrons, it requires 2 shells. Hence, in lithium, the second shell is the valence shell, while the first shell is the inner shell. 2 electrons will be accommodated in the inner shell and will be called inner electrons. 1 electron will be accommodated in the valence shell and will be called valence electron. Nucleus will attract the valence electron, as shown by purple arrow. The inner electrons will exert repulsive forces on the valence electron, as shown by the red arrows. These repulsive forces will reduce the nuclear charge to some extent, and the reduced nuclear charge is called effective nuclear charge. This is called effective because after the action of the repulsive forces, the net reduced nuclear charge will remain effective on the valence electron. The actual nuclear charge has been shielded or reduced in this process, therefore, it is called the shielding effect by the inner electrons. Hence, in lithium the shielding effect occurs to some extent. Now let's take a sodium element. Sodium lies in the third period and in the first group. The atomic number of sodium is 11, that means it has 11 protons in its nucleus, and therefore, 11 electrons are rotating around the nucleus. For accommodating these 11 electrons, it requires 3 shells. Hence, in sodium, the third shell is the valence shell, while the first and the second shells are the inner shells. 2 electrons will be accommodated in the first shell, while 8 electrons will be accommodated in the second shell, and hence 10 electrons will be considered as inner electrons. The 11th electron will be accommodated in the valence shell and will be called valence electron in sodium. Nucleus will attract the valence electron as shown by the purple arrow. The inner electrons will exert repulsive forces on the valence electron, as shown by the red arrows. These repulsive forces will reduce the nuclear charge to some more extent as compared to the lithium element. Hence, in sodium, greater shielding effect as compared to lithium will be observed. As we have seen that the shielding effect in lithium is greater than hydrogen, and the shielding effect in sodium is greater than lithium, hence, The trend of the shielding effect is increasing from top to bottom in a group in the periodic table. The increasing trend is shown by the red triangle in the animation. Now to understand the trend of the shielding effect in a period, let's take the case of the second period. The first element of the second period is lithium, while the last element of the second period is neon. We will discuss briefly the lithium element again. As we have seen already that there are two inner electrons in lithium while there is only one valence electron. These two inner electrons are responsible for the shielding effect in lithium element. Now let's discuss the shielding effect in neon element, the last element of the second period. The atomic number of neon is 10, that means it has 10 protons in its nucleus, and therefore, 10 electrons are rotating around the nucleus. For accommodating these 10 electrons, it requires two shells. Hence, in neon, the second shell is the valence shell, while the first shell is the inner shell. Two electrons will be accommodated in the first shell, while remaining 8 electrons will be accommodated in the valence shell. Therefore, 8 electrons will be valence electrons, while only the 2 electrons will behave like the inner electrons in neon. Nucleus will attract these 8 valence electrons as shown by the purple arrows. The 2 inner electrons will exert repulsive forces on the valence electrons and will cause shielding effect. Here the point is to be noted is that the inner electrons in both lithium and neon are 2. The trend of the shielding effect along the period from left to right can be visualized by keeping the fact in mind that all the elements of the second period contains equal inner electrons, as it was observed in the case of lithium and neon. Both the elements have 2 inner electrons. Since the inner electrons are same along the period in the periodic table, which leads to the fact that shielding effect also remains same along the period in the periodic table. The same shielding effect is shown by the red rectangle in this animation. Thank you for watching. Please encourage us by subscribing our work.